And now we will learn how to deposit money that comes in from the owner's personal funds. A deposit can only be one of three things. It could be income from a customer or client, which is what we learned about in the previous video. It can be a transfer from another business bank account, which is what we will learn in the next video, or it can be investment from the owner. Whenever money comes from a personal non-business account into one of the business bank accounts, that's an investment from the owner, and the proper account to record that into is Holden's Capital. For example, let's imagine on July 4, Holden transferred $900 from his non-business personal account into the TNM business bank account, and the bank gave transaction number 44556. Let's take a look at how to record this. This transaction is from the TNM bank account, so we click the TNM register. We put in the date July 4th. Click once for the calendar box, click the forward arrow to bring it to July, and click July 4. Put in the online transfer number. By the way, when you click in the number field, QuickBooks suggests a number. Hit the back arrow and type in the actual number, which I believe was 44556. So we type in 44556. Now, there's no payee, or you don't have to put a payee if you're depositing money into the account. But the most important point here is that this account is Holden's Capital. Holden's Capital. This is our first transaction with Holden's Capital, and it will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $900. We are depositing to the TNM bank. So put 900 in the deposit column in the row of the transaction. When we click record, we can see that QuickBooks updates the balance of the TNM bank account. And now when we open the trial balance, we can see that the balance of the TNM bank account has increased to $1,400, and Holden's Capital, which represents the investment that Holden made from his personal to the business, shows up on the trial balance for the first time as $900. Let's try one more example and see if we can predict what the results will be. July 5th, Holden took $200 cash from his wife's pocketbook and deposited it into the Chase business bank account, transaction number 77889. Well, Chase bank account will increase by 200, and Holden's Capital will also increase by 200. So, when we finish this transaction, Chase bank should be 2,700, and Holden's Capital should be 1,100. The transaction happened from the Chase bank account. So we put in the date, July 5th. We put in the transaction number, which I believe was 77889. So 77889. And of course, we don't have to put a payee if we're depositing into a bank account. And again, because the money came from non-business personal funds, the account we choose is Holden's Capital. Make sure you put it in the deposit column. And after you type the money amount, click record. Now when we look at the trial balance, we can see the numbers are exactly what we expected. Chase Bank increased to 2,700, and Holden's Capital, which is his overall investment from personal into business, $1,100.